on, we've made our way into the kitchen with our first guest. And I would just like to say, when it comes to breakfast, a lot of us can get stuck in a rut. Wouldn't you guys agree?
100%.
Yeah. And listen, if you're a busy mom, you know it can be very difficult to even get breakfast in your children's mouths while you're running out of the door.
It's like, eat it.
So today, our very good friend, Danielle Kartes, is back. And she's going to show us not one, but two ways to make our breakfasts easy and joyful. Right, Danielle?
We need options. Everybody needs options. Yeah. And breakfast is that meal where you get started and you're like, I mean, it's the first thing you put in your body for the day. Hopefully you've had your water. But you really want to fuel your kids, you want to fuel your family, and you don't want to get sick. And I know we have this affinity for fun, sweet breakfast, but sometimes you need that good protein, the good fat, all that good stuff.
Sweet and savory. Now, the savory, you're talking Cameron's language.
He's so
happy.
This is him.
Good, healthy, fast, happy day off, right? I love that.
When I was creating this recipe, I specifically thought about Cameron. I was like, you know what? This is perfect for Cameron.
All right, Cameron, you dig in. I'm sure you've got the savory. Maria, get in there. You too.
Yes. Yeah.
And, oh, so you have both.
We have both.
Oh, this is very exciting.
And it's awesome. It's potatoes and eggs, but it's in a different way. It's kind of fun, like this avocado bowl.
So what are we doing?
Right now, we're going to make our pesto.
Okay, but we're making two.
We're doing a red pesto. We're going to do two. So next, we're going to do our granola, but we won't get ahead of ourselves.
So first, we're doing a red pesto potato bowl.
First, we're doing the red pesto potato bowl.
And then we're doing a granola.
Yes, we've already pre-roasted our beautiful potatoes. So this is olive oil, salt and pepper. You throw them in the oven. They're delicious. And you guys, I feel like a lot of people are afraid of potatoes these days with all the multiple diets, but they're loaded with potassium. They're so good for you, and they keep you full.
That's true. Okay, so we'll set those aside.
Friend. Yeah. We want to be a potato in a good way.
And now we're going to make our red pepper pesto.
Yeah. Okay, so go ahead and throw your roasted peppers in. Okay. You can roast them yourself or you can buy them in a jar.
All right.
We've got Parmesan, all the usual suspects in a pesto. We've got a little bit of lemon juice, some garlic, sun-dried tomatoes because these pack a punch. They're nice and tangy. Okay. When you're eating healthy food, you want to think of things that are really flavorful and absolutely delicious.
Right.
So in goes our walnuts.
Okay, and our parm?
Yes, and your parm. Okay. Everybody in the pool.
Everybody
in the pool.
All right.
And then here is this little dude.
What is that?
This is flatleaf parsley.
Okay.
Whatever parsley you have, there's nothing wrong with curly parsley. It tastes literally just about identical.
Is there a reason why your walnuts are not pine nuts?
They're really, pine nuts are super expensive.
Yeah. I love you for that.
Yeah, and they're a soft, tender nut, and actually a walnut's got way more nutrition than a pine nut. I mean, I'm not a chemist or a doctor or whatever you call it. Walnuts have got so much more nutrition, and they're soft. They've got a little bitterness to them. I would pick a walnut over pine nut any day.
And they're shaped like a brain, because they're good for your brain.
Yes, they're good for your brain. Yeah.
So a little bit of lemon juice.
Yes. Okay. Salt and pepper to taste, whatever you got. Garlic.
Okay, don't be shy.
And this is one thing I like to do is pulse it a little bit first just to get everybody all
melded together.
Get everybody
in there.
The little button on the handle there.
Oh, I'll do it, sorry.
You were so the pro of this.
Perfect, there you go.
She's a bit of a... Okay, so now you pour the olive oil slowly in there?
No, you know what? I stop him.
Okay.
Because I don't want it to completely emulsify and then give you like sort of like a peanut butter consistency.
Oh gosh, look at that.
I like texture. So I think when you're eating, you want little bits of texture and fun stuff.
Okay,
and then just pulse, and he's done. He's done.
All right,
that's it. And then we take the rest of the olive oil and pop him in the top.
Okay.
And now, okay, so here's our egg. Debbie likes a fully poached egg.
Yes.
There is no runny in Debbie's egg.
Yeah. Everyone here knows how I feel about runny eggs.
Yeah. And this is so cool, you guys. Look at this little slotted dealy, whatever.
Wait a minute, Danielle. Do we put the pesto on first or the egg on first?
Well, I like to put the egg on first, and then we can top it with the pesto so you get everybody. Here we go.
Okay,
fully hard-cooked egg.
Thank you very much.
There's no jello in there. And then, now we've got our delicious sauce. You want to go for it?
Okay.
And this is really cool, too. So here's our avocado.
That's what I'm talking about.
This is, you guys... This is like the king of life.
Avocado. So good for you.
And if you can't eat anything in the morning, if you don't have any time, just pop an avocado out like this. I'm not kidding.
Listen,
a little bit of salt and lemon.
I have a friend who eats two avocados and two mangoes and pretty much calls it a day.
And they're probably full. Is that you?
Is it me?
Asking for a friend, is this normal?
Maybe someday.
Okay. All right. Asking for a friend. Perfect. So we pop our little avocado on.
And these are pickled onions?
Marinated onions and olive oil and salt and pepper. Takes the bite out. They're delicious.
Oh, my goodness. All right, Danielle. I'm going to town on this one while you prepare our sweet one.
So next comes up the sweet.
Okay.
And it's a rodeo. Okay. So some people do love the sweet breakfast. There's nothing wrong with it. I'm a sweet breakfast fan, too.
Yeah,
We've got our oats.
Okay.
I'm going to use this.
Just regular rolled oats?
Yes, regular old rolled oats. Rolled oats. Okay, and here is our almond butter.
Nice.
Almond butter.
You can use any sort of nut butter. You can use any nut butter. If you've got peanut butter, don't go out and buy almond butter because it's expensive.
Yes, it is.
I mean, you want to use what you actually have on hand. That's what makes cooking fun. I feel like if you have to go buy a huge ingredient list, then it's not, it takes a little bit of the joy out of it.
Right.
We've got cocoa nibs, which are just a little outer hull of the little chocolate pod. Mm. So if you don't have cocoa nibs, use chocolate chips. We've got brown sugar for a little sweetness. You don't want to use brown sugar. Go ahead and use like agave or honey, whatever you want.
Okay.
And then over here, we've got vanilla, cinnamon, Himalayan pink salt.
Why Himalayan pink salt?
It just has a little bit of a mineral content to it.
Okay.
And then.
I'm loving what I'm hearing about.
Isn't this good? Yeah.
Here's all the cinnamon that's so good for you.
So cinnamon's really good for you too. Super antioxidants. And then we've got our coconut. Mm. And this is a little secret weapon too. I know we're running out of time, so I'm like, this is our egg. So if you like clumpy granola.
I do.
I like a clumpy granola.
Me too.
I feel like it's a huge miss if you have a granola that's
and
like.
It all falls apart.
It all falls apart. I'm like, that's cereal. Dry. There's no goo on it.
Well, it's cereal. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Not granola.
Yeah.
I'm with you.
Yep. Okay, so we're going to mix it all together.
Oh
yes.
My gosh, and you pour the egg white in.
Yes.
It's pour the
egg white in. It's the binder.
That's
Isn't that so cool?
Okay, so we pour it on our pan.
And we're going to pretend that this is perfectly mixed.
There you go.
It is.
It's perfectly mixed. Okay.
Now, how long does this toast in the oven? By the way, the coconut is going to toast and be delicious.
Oh, it's so good. It's like 25 minutes.
At what temperature, Danielle?
350 degrees.
Okay.
And the cool part about this is that this stuff lasts for legitimately a couple of weeks.
Oh, yeah.
Put them in an airtight container.
It's so good.
And it's so good for you.
That's delicious.
It's delicious.
So stuff and you're adding a little bit of fruit and you're making the bowl beautiful. I want to make sure we have time to ask about the second edition of your first book.
Yes, you guys.
My Heart's
so
Table.
Excited. Second edition is coming out. We went with a publisher. They're like, hey, you guys have so much fun stuff to say. We're going to say it. So you can actually pre-order the book right now. It comes out September 3rd. We're just so blessed. I just feel so excited. It's
we're
gonna be
so
wonderful.
Happy. I mean, Danielle, you're all grown up now.
From the first time you were here. I know. I love you guys.
You go ahead and finish that up and have a little taste
yogurt.
At the same time.
Yes, and honey.
These recipes will be at HallmarkChannel.com. And for more from Danielle, visit
rustic, joyfulfood.com.